I just want to say thank you to everybody for being here. It's a great, great occasion for me, and I think it's going to be for you too.
Oh, yeah.
It's a great honor.
Thank you.
Mr. Patrick Hallinan and the staff of Arlington National Cemetery. We present Mr. Rodriguez with a Where Valor Rests, a booklet of Arlington National Cemetery.
Thank you very much. Sure. Thank you.
Good afternoon, and I want to welcome you to Arlington National Cemetery, where for 150 years our nation is gathered here to honor her fallen heroes and warriors. These sacred grounds stand as a lasting tribute to the 400,000 Americans who lie here in rest. And as you look upon these rows of headstones, each name etched in stone is a brick in the foundation of our freedom that we stand upon today. But I encourage you to remember this. No plot at Arlington National Cemetery can be purchased. Each must be earned. And Private Miguel Vera Rodriguez has earned his place in these hallowed and sacred grounds for his faithful service to our nation and heeding our nation's call and serving in the Korean War. It was there that he gave the ultimate sacrifice when he volunteered to remain behind on an ordered withdrawal. For his actions, he has earned a Purple Heart and the Medal of Honor. My friends and family, I invite you now to join me in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. For our brother-in-arms, our nation bestows military honors. In life, Private Vera Rodriguez has honored the flag. Now in death, the flag will honor him.
Firing party! Fire three volleys!
On behalf of the Rodriguez Vera family, I'd like to thank all of you for taking the time today and joining us during this significant event as we honored Medal of Honor recipient, Private Miguel Armando Rodriguez Vera, United States Army.
On September 21st, 1952, Lord, Miguel Armando Vera did this very act. As he was going down the hill and he was going to the Battalion 8 station, Lord, you gave him courage, you gave him honor that he described in his life. Another verse in the Bible, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave, but he gave the ultimate sacrifice.
And 10 years ago, a committee was formed to review the records of nearly 7,000 Distinguished Service Cross recipients from World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. And from that, 600 were further reviewed and researched, and out of that, 24 of those were found to be deserving of a higher award. And Miguel was one of those.
This certificate is signed by the Commanding General and the Command Sergeant Major of the 2nd Infantry Division, still headquartered in Korea, over 60 years after the war, with probably one of our strongest allies.
Thank you, sir.
God bless.
Our nation, our Army, and our Warrior Division are strong because of the Private Veras out there. He was a young, ordinary man who, under the most chaotic and difficult conditions, displayed extraordinary courage at the risk of his own life to protect his fellow soldiers and accomplish the mission.
Private Vera's heroic actions 62 years ago in Chulwon, Korea, are an incredible illustration of the competence, commitment, and character resident in our warfighters, our veterans, and our Army.
Today, the 2nd Infantry Division expands upon the bedrock of freedom forged by Private Vera's valor, so that future U.S. and Republic of Korea generations may know what Private Vera and others like him defended, the hope and promise of a better tomorrow.
Today, we are living proof and the fruits of his noble sacrifice and extraordinary heroism displayed here 62 years ago. It's because of men like Private Vera and his legacy that we are proud to wear this uniform and the Indian head patch, standing shoulder to shoulder with our ROC allies as we continue to strengthen our historic alliance.
We must always remember the uncommon valor and self-sacrifice of Private Vera, an extraordinary American and an exemplary soldier who gave his last full measure of devotion on a distant battlefield in preservation of freedom for our nation and our allies.
Second to none.
The 2nd Infantry Division, Medal of Honor recipient. Miguel Armando Vera was awarded the Medal of Honor for his historic actions at Chulwon, Korea while serving with the 2nd Infantry Division during the Korean War. On September 21, 1952, while Private Vera's unit attempted to retake the right sector of Old Baldy, it came under heavy fire at close range and was forced back. Private Vera selfishly chose to stay behind and cover the troops' withdrawal and lost his life during this action. Private Vera's extraordinary heroism and selflessness at the cost of his own life are in keeping with the highest traditions of the military service, the 2nd Infantry Division, and the U.S. Army. Fight tonight.
Thank you. What a greeting. You know, I'm so humble, and I'm so proud. And, you know, I met Joe at the ceremony, and we kind of clicked it off, you know, and so that's why I'm here. And I call Joe a brother. And I call Nando a brother. And it just seems like naturally I should call him Nando. You know, in the military, we try to live with philosophy that we don't leave a brother behind. We do whatever we have to do to defend our brothers, to protect our brothers. And this is what Nando did. You know, I received the Congressional Medal of Honor at the same time that Nando was awarded. And I, too, had the Distinguished Service Cross. And, you know, I often reflect that, why did it take so long to recognize individuals that should have received the Congressional Medal of Honor? Myself, I never worry about it because I figured this was it. You know, you've done your best, and let it go. And this happened. And this is why I met Joe at the ceremony. And I was very, very, very impressed. But you know, it's better late than never, because never we have to live with that burden. You know, a country that doesn't honor its heroes is a statement I picked up. And we're a lost country. We must honor our heroes.
alive or fallen. You know, and there are so many that give the ultimate sacrifice. And to me, when I look at Arlington Cemetery, it does something to me. I mean, I can't explain it to you, but I know the sacrifice it has taken to secure this country, our freedoms. And we take it for granted. We take it for granted. And see, Nando, in his sense, he knew what he was doing was very important. He knew. And, you know, all of us in the military, we know. We may not seem like we know, but we know. Okay, our families are very important to us. Our rights for free movement, our rights for free speech, to do what we want to do, just our self-rights. And now we got a situation where people are trying to take that away from us. It ain't gonna happen. It ain't gonna happen. I don't care if we have to feel every acre happen. Because, you know, this is what we're about, living free. You know, when I reflect back and look at the people that I know that lost their lives, you know, being a Medal of Honor recipient, it's kind of hard for me to talk about Nando because I have to go back to myself. And it's a belief you have. And my old saying is, you do what you gotta do. And Nando did the same thing. He said to himself, this is what I'm saying, I have to help my brothers. I have to defend my brothers. And if it takes my life, that's what I will give. And that's what he gave. He gave the ultimate sacrifice. You know, I'm feeling it in my heart that there's some closure now. And thanks to Joe, he worked hard, and Joe's a good man. Really worked hard. And it helps the family. It really does. But, you know, there are people that will just answer the call. It's nothing that you can make happen. It's built in you. It will just happen. You can't go out. I hear people say, win the Medal of Honor. You cannot win the Medal of Honor. There's no win. There's no award. It's received. And Nando was the one that looked up on and said, how did we miss this? This man really gave this ultimate. He gave it all. He didn't hesitate to do what he had to do to save his fallen comrades. And, you know, I'm so honored just to be able to talk to man. I feel like I know him. And I never met him. I feel like I know his whole family, such a wonderful family, the Rodriguez family. And they're taking me in, and I'm really overwhelmed. But getting back to Nando, Nando is the one of the type of spirit that you can't even put your hands on. This is not given to everyone. And, you know, he knew what he had to do, and he did it without hesitation. And, you know, that. Similar in my situation, but I look at Nando's and I say, you know, I didn't do anything, not compared to Nando. And Nando was here to receive the Congressional Medal of Honor. I was standing up and he was laying down. He's not here. And, you know, I thank Nando because Nando allows us to continue our lives as we wish. And so, you know, I want to thank his family for all the effort that they put into recognizing Nando's accomplishments and bringing him home. And, you know, now I hate to put all this emphasis on Joe, but I know he worked his can off. And I want to thank Joe myself. You know, but this is what we have to do. We have to recognize our heroes. If we fail to do that, then we fail as a country. Because we don't care. That's about what it amounts to. And, you know, my heart's with Nando. I'm proud of it. And, you know, it doesn't happen often, but it does happen. And I'm going to go back to a point that I know everyone interested in. I just left a ceremony in D.C. about 3 weeks ago at the Honors Award. And at the award, they recognized the Puerto Rican's family with the Gold Medal Award. Okay. You know, it's a minority, it's tough. You know it. I know it because I'm a minority. And we get overlooked sometimes. But we work hard and we try to do our best. I had an old saying, you have to do 125% because 110% ain't going to cut it. You know, and I was happy at that award when they awarded the Puerto Ricans a long due over award. You should have had it years ago to be recognized. And I was honored at that same award ceremony. But you know, I was in Green Beret back in 1961, and during the time of the Bay of Pigs invasion, Cuba. And I was able to work with a lot of Latinos. I spent my time in Dominican Republic 2 years. I spent 4 years in Panama. So I learned the Latinos, their culture, their ways of life, their thinking. And they are very proud people, very. And they're very family already. And losing Nando and not being able to bring him home, I know how you feel. But now you can have that closure because it was a good ceremony. And I think he's looking at us right now. He's appreciative of that. He's happy because he wanted to do what he could for his country. And I just want to thank you for inviting me here just to say a few words. You know, I feel like family. And I feel like I personally knew Nando, which is not possible. But in my heart, I do know him. He was a brother. All men in uniform are brothers. And we'll go down together. That's what we should do, to the last man standing. Leave no man behind. Thank you.
Since I was a little boy and I found out that he was killed, I always thought about how, why, where. Sergeant Carvel, Colonel Carvel now, really, we spent hours on the phone, him telling me what kind of guy Miguel was. 5'4", 135 pounds, soaking wet. He said he was a great guy. Great human being and my hero.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shore.